家好。
My name is Alex, and I'm running the Fab Lab in Amsterdam since about 5 years. We are very fortunate to be in this very beautiful, oldest building of the city, which has been built in 1488 already.
1488. 所以我们Alex 他是在阿姆斯特丹呢，就是主持这个 Fab Lab 的艺术家。那其实他们的所在的地方从1488年就盖好了一个老房子，非常漂亮。
So what you see here is one of a pottery project we did, that we collected some leaves of grass, as you said. We laser cutted it and we put it back on the street so people can find some poles on the.
他们呢，就是在路上捡一些树叶，然后刻镭射雕刻上一些诗句，然后把它撒回那个街道上，让人们就可以把它带回家做纪念。
Okay, so here's the building. So the entire first floor is the Fab Lab Amsterdam and the Maker's Guild, as I will tell more about it later.
所以是这个房子呢，就是他们的阿姆斯特丹 Fab Lab 的所在地，就是一楼，一整个一楼都是。
And so it's very central located, which helps a lot that people have good access to the lab. So it's just a 5 minutes walk from.The central station.
对，它非常的在位在市中心，大概离车站才5分钟，大家可以很容易的到达这个地点。
Yeah, this is one part how it looks from inside some time ago.
对，这是之前在这个内部的一个样子。
This is exactly the same room like 300 years ago.
300年前它是长这样子。
So.The Fab Lab Amsterdam is hosted by the VAR Society, an institute for art, science and technology located in Amsterdam.
它是由这个在阿姆斯特丹的艺术科学与科技学院所成立的。
Yeah, we're about 60 people and we do about 40 projects a year, ranging from education, care, art, sustainability and so on.
我们大概有60位 40 就是一年大概有40个就是不同的 project.
So and one of the things we are a well-known institution in the Netherlands is our approach for how we do our project. So and that's what we call in one create users as designers.
那其实我们一直以来呢，就是希望说使用者、使用科技的人，他也是设计师。
So with users as designers, we mean that we on the very first stage, we got in touch to the end user, the one who will use our project, our device or whatever piece of software it is, and start talking what they want because we want to make something which they love, not that they have to read a book to understand it.
那所谓 users as designers 的意思就是说，我们希望在设计产品的第一阶段就可以跟终端使用者有一个交流，然后真正知道说他们喜欢跟需要什么样的产品。
So I would like to show you like two healthcare projects which we are still working on. This is a little movie of a glucose meter.
那接下来是两个我们还在进行的关于这个医疗照护的 project。
I wouldn't call it stressful, but sometimes it still is, yeah.
But stressing is very important thing by diabetes, because when you see the result of the meter...
You're not afraid, but you're very anxious to see what it tells you.
Doesn't agree with your own feelings, then you're disappointed. It's the same when you do an exam, and you study it very well.And you don't get it.
I get emotional of it. I see that, oh yes.
You are not so sure about your own body.
It says 16.8.8, then it's still 17 to me.
It goes from 0 till...
Everybody's looking at the figure,
mm-hmm.
and they never, ever considered doing it differently. large group of people, for instance, when they have type 2 diabetes, especially for those people, maybe it's not needed that it is that accurate. That they maybe do it in a completely different way. The shape and the way how it's done, it's kind of, it's giving me a spring idea.
Mm-hmm.
So in a way that's already making me happy.
For me it's immediately clear.
Okay. And
it's really, yeah. It's echt helder. It's not so strict like an instrument. I feel more with that than with this. It's easier.
So you see, I really like this example, because actually what we did is just simplifying things, because these people with diabetes, they get stressed if they measure like 60.7. They just want to know it's balanced, it's high or low, that's it.
他们不喜欢看到那么多数字，他们只是想知道说，哎，现在是低还是高，他的血糖的那个程度。
At this very moment, we're trying to reverse engineering these little strips, because that's the only thing we are really depending on the industry, and that's of course their business model. So we try to make them ourselves using the FabLab methodology.
所以我们呢，其实是自己用FabLab 里面的科技呢来做这个血糖机。
I would show you another project, which for me is one of the most promising project, but it's also very challenging. It is together with our friends in Indonesia, where we have established a fab lab in Yogyakarta. We are trying to engineer a low-cost lower knee prosthesis using local material.
这个project 我觉得自己是非常有兴趣，但是它挑战性也非常高。这个是跟印尼的Yogyakarta 这个 Fab Lab 一起合作，要做出这个平价的义肢。
So at the moment we have we are in the state of final prototype force testing with machines.
我们现在的阶段呢，就是用机器在测试一个最后的原型。
Now, to me, the most amazing part of the very promising part of it is that we try to give to give the people a new mindset.
我觉得最有趣，就是说最有希望的部分，就是我们给人们带来一个新的观念，一个想法。
You have to realize that even in the Western world, people who are using prosthesis, they are totally dependent on orthopedics.
在西方呢，你要用义肢，你要有矫正师的那个认可。
We believe, again, our users as designers approach. We believe that you have to become friends with your prosthesis. And while it also has been scientifically proven that our roll-off curve varies over different kind of surfaces, we decided to make it adjustable, so you can actually just try it out yourself.
对我们来讲呢，你要带着一个义肢，表示你要跟他相处很长时间，跟他做朋友。所以我们测试的这个义肢是希望说，根据不同的表面，然后呢，它是做可以调整式的义肢。
And of course, it's a collaborative work, so we need, since it's an orthopedic device, we need to have some good backup. And for me, this is the most inspiring power force for me, Dr. Professor Bert Orton, who always told me, you know, Alex, you can make a new feet design. It's no problem for you. And I always said to him, well, I'm not an orthopedic, how I am to make a feet? And then he said, like, because you're not an orthopedic and you don't have all these boundaries, you will make a good one.
当然这是一个集体的工作啦，大家要合作。那这个 这一位这个矫正师呢，他其实鼓励我很多，因为我常就跟他说，哎，我不是矫正师，我根本不知道怎么样做一个义肢。可是，Bert 他说，其实正因为你不是专业，所以你不会被一些框架绑住。
So as you have seen in Jens's movie, I had the pleasure that Jens visited us in Yogyakarta as well, and he get his hands on to produce a feed.
那这个是印尼的这个 Fab Lab， 他也就是跟我一起参与在做这个义肢。
So this is like a 5 euro feed using local wood and a little bit of polyurethane resin.
这原料大概才5欧元左右。 用一些当地的木头啦，还有中间那个树枝。
Then of course, one very complicated part is the connector that you have like 360 degrees freedom with your leg on both sides, on the top and the bottom.
关节也是很重要的部位，你要在这个膝盖啦，还有这个脚踝的部分都要可以有360度这样的一个空间可以旋转。
So we started making some 3D prints of these joints. And then we ended up using a hard wood, and there it is.
那一开始用一些3D的列印技术做关节，然后用实木来做这个支架，那这就是成果。
So this prototype was actually completed 4 days ago. So now we are coming in this very interesting state to try it out, doing pressure tests, and then I would hope over 3 months we can fit it to the first person.
对，那这个其实这个原型是4天前才做好的，我们再做一些测试，就能够使用在真人身上。Then
while we were doing these connectors, our friends in Indonesia tried some traditional technique, which is called bamboo coiling, to make a socket.
那我们在印尼的朋友，他们做这样子的一个竹编的线圈。
But unfortunately, it's way too rough on the inside, so it would really hurt you, so we used this other method here.
但是因为它里面比较粗，会摩擦到皮肤，所以我们还是用刚刚看到那个3D列印的那个方法。
And since Indonesia is full of bamboo, I was trying to machining bamboo rod on the lathe, which goes surprisingly good.
那其实印尼有产很多竹子，所以我们要在足部的部分也放了一小段竹的那个材料，那其实效果非常好。
And then the other method we are still working on it, but it starts to be promising. Is like we tried a composite using natural fiber. This is cocos fiber to the left, and pineapple fiber, the white one, and banana bark.
好，那我们其实也在，当然现在那个矫正师还在测试阶段嘛，哈，可是我们有想要融入一些天然的素材，比如说不同的植物的纤维，像是凤梨啦，或者是桦树等等。
Yeah, so we took the pineapple fiber and we put it with our hands also to make very thin fibers and combined it with polyurethane rubber.
那我们呢用一些我们用手把它就是做成这样的形状，用那个凤梨的纤维。
And what is nice is that it's even breathable. You can blow through, which makes very sense in hot countries like here.
它的好处就是说它是可以呼吸的，你这样吹气过去，它是会透气的。
Then again, always expert meetings, so we show our prototypes to the experts and get their feedback, and we go on from there.
那当然，我们需要跟一些各类的专家开会，然后呢，看完会后得到他们的回馈之后，我们再去改善。
And this is another device that we are using, which has developed by the UMCG Groningen University, which is called the Knee Walker.
Knee Walker. Oh, 就是用膝盖走路的这样的一个装置。
Yeah, so that this allows you to get the experience how it is how to walk with a prosthesis. And on the other side, we can test our prototypes ourselves first.Instead of bothering the real users.
那 Knee Walker 这一个原型，它就是可以帮助我们去感受你怎么样用义肢走路。那你可以因为你自身有感受到，所以创造出更实际的商品。
Okay, how much time do we have? Okay, so I want to show you some other stuff we do, of course, because we don't do only healthcare.So one thing I developed 3 years ago was like a foosball table.
这是我三年前的设计，就是那个手足球桌。
And it was a really nice project because the idea was if you make one yourself, you go through all the processes that you can use in a fab lab.
那好处就是说，你如果自己做过，你就可以走过那整个 fab lab 制造的过程。
Have a look.
我们看一下片。
Concept of soccer table a little bit further and make it really our own thing and very importantly make it open source. It could be a very good learning project since you go through all kinds of digitalfabrication methods.
We've got video camera in it, we've got electronic scoring system, we've got sensors, so everything is interactive and automatic.Something more sexy, you know, like something that is nicer to see than just LEDs.
E c'è la rete olandese con dei dubbi sulla posizione di l'altro giocatore.
What I really liked in this project was that actually.My students convinced me to make it interactive because I just wanted to do an ordinary one, and that was really enjoyable.
那我很喜欢这一个计划的原因是因为一开始我只想做一个很普通的那个手足球桌，可是我学生呢鼓励我做一个可以互动的。
Yeah, so like every year, I'd like to challenge myself with one new project if it is possible to do in a fab lab or not. So.And this was another very beautiful thing is that I had a student from the Design Academy in Eindhoven who came to the lab to make some tests on the big milling machine to machine wood textures in wood or just textures into wood as you can see.
我其实每年都想要做一个挑战自己做一个新的东西然后那这个是我其中一个学生他所做的用木头做的一些美丽的刻纹。
So very simply, by the end of the day, when he took these photos, I saw this and he thought, like, wow, that's amazing. So I asked him, would you be in for to wrap this texture there around my bass guitar because I wanted to make a bass guitar.
对，那我就觉得看到这个花，我就觉得很漂亮，然后我就问他说，可不可以？因为我想做一个吉他，那可不可以用在我的那个低音吉他上面？
So it was like a ridiculous amount of machining, but so we spent like about 40 hours machining. But here you have it, like the same structure in a base using 3D milling technology.
我们大概花了40个小时在操作机器，但是它现在终于成型。
Then we also did the neck from scratch using incorporating a truss rod so you can adjust it.
那我们也把我们也是从头做那个吉他那个柄。
And then of course a lot of handwork. As you said, I really liked it that you always say that we use our hands. You really need to use a lot of your hands. The machines can't do it for you.
是，我们也有许多的手工。那也很喜欢刚才的讲者提到说，我们除了机器以外，最重要还是那个手的那个温度跟感情。
And then since I'm not a luthier, of course I made a big mistake, so I had to do this operation and put the entire bass back into the machine.And mill out the pocket for the bridge again.
那我在操作这个时候有点恍神，我应该要把整个机器都放进去。
But we made it, and this guy was like the first who was trying it out in the lab.
但是最终我们还是把它做出来。这个是我们实验室第一个握着把吉他的人。
And by the way, it's still hanging there. So if you're ever in Amsterdam, please come and play.
这吉他还挂在那边，你们有去阿姆斯特丹可以去玩一下。
Yeah, so actually I wanted to add also like what you said, because I had after 5 years of running the Fab Lab Amsterdam, I was getting a bit tired of this kind of connections which we always use, but there is actually nothing wrong about it.
那其实我主持了这个 Fab Lab 5年的时间呢，我现在觉得说像我们这样子切割东西拼接起来，其实已经有一点不是那么有趣了，虽然这个也没有什么错。
So when I started to look at old traditional Japanese wood joinery, I really thought, how is it possible that we now have digital precision and we make actually poorer joints like our ancestors did like 500 years ago? That can't be right.
对，那我看到这些切割木头，我会觉得说，因为我们现在有那么精细的这个机器，可是为什么还是在做跟500年一样的这种切割的东西呢？
So this brought me to the concept of maker skills, which should combine traditional craftsmanship and digital fabrication and biotechnology. Because I believe then we have truly beautiful products.
所以我就想要组织这样子一个创客的一个交流，那可以连接像是手工艺啊、数位制造，还有生物科技。
So if you look at the little shapes there, these lampshades, this was something that I really liked as well, which is an old-fashioned craft, which is steam bending wood. All you need for this is to make just a box and a steam engine, basically.
这我们看到刚刚那一张上面有很多那个灯哈，那其实是用像这种用蒸汽去把木头就是转弯的一个器具。
So we basically combined, we used burl wood and laser-cutted this patron in it, and cooked it, and then bended it.
我们就是把那个木头加热，然后呢，利用热蒸汽呢，让它可以有那个柔软度，然后可以弯成像这样子。
So you can see how you can make beautiful things with really old-fashioned technology and digital technology together.
那我们就可以用这个新的科技跟旧的素材呢，做出这么美丽的作品。
Then a little bit more sophisticated project I just completed, or we just completed 2 months ago, was this was a dining table based on George Nakashima's design.
我们在两个月前呢，才刚刚完成的，就是一个餐桌的设计，它是非常 George.
Nakashima.
George Nakashima 的设计原型。
So I was really lucky to find this kind of Chilean laurel burlwood plates. They are both 1 meter by 85 centimeters and 60 millimeter thick initially.
那我幸运可以找到这一块很珍就是很稀有的智利的木头。
So the idea was to combine again digital machining and handcraft. So we decided.To make this Japanese wood joinery all by hand using Japanese chisels.
那我们有用一些日本的就是古法来做这样，就是参与把它融入在里面。
So this is my cooperator Carsten Lemme, and he pulled it off in 2 weeks to make the entire construction of the table.
那这一个是我的伙伴，他几乎是在做整个桌子这个就是他造型的部分。
And I myself, I machined the entire tabletop, and it took me afterwards 3 weeks to finishing using an old kind of method. But there again, you know, you cannot make the perfect surface finishing with a machine. You have to do it by hand.
对，那其实几乎我们光是这个外表表面的处理就花了3个礼拜。就是它其实没有那么容易，所以我们还是要用手做一些细工的部分。
And now it stands in my home, and I love it.
在我的家里。
So like my last message to you is actually that there's a lot of people talking about fab labs and machines and so on. But you know, like the machines, they cannot do anything for you. They're totally stupid. They don't have any intelligence. Everything you have to put into it.That it's coming out like you wanted. So, Fab Lab is not about machines. It's about you, the people, and the community.
那其实我要传递最重要就是说 ，Fab Lab 它不是机器导向，因为机器它是没有任何的那个想法的。那重点是人，你要把你的创意跟你的想法加注到这个机器里面。
Thanks very much.
谢谢大家。